Hi, I'm Neeraj from Pacific Automation, and in this video, I'm going to run you through how we specify new or replacement inductive sensors. Here at Pacific Automation, we distribute Balluff's range of inductive sensors, which includes over 2,000 variants. Whenever we specify a part, the first step is to consider the application so we can identify any special requirements that may be needed. In most cases, a general purpose sensor is sufficient, but you may have advanced requirements such as high pressure rated sensors, hygienic sensors for food or pharmaceutical applications, detection of non-ferrous metals such as aluminium or brass, magnetic field and weld splatter resistant sensors for welding applications, high temperature sensors, high frequency sensors for speed detection and applications, or hazardous area certified sensors. The second factor we need to consider is the body style and sensing distance required. With inductive sensors, the size of the sensor correlates with the sensing distance it can achieve, so we need to find the optimum balance between these two factors. Inductive sensors typically come in barrel or cubic housings. Standard housing range from M5 to M30 for barrel sensors and 5mm to 110mm for cubic sensors. The installation of the sensor needs to be considered as well. Sensors can either be installed flush in the material or bracket, or can have a non-flush or quasi-flush sensing phase. The advantage of non-flush or quasi-flush sensing phase is that you can get extended sensing range with the same body style. We next need to consider the sensors with electrical interface to the control system. Most sensors now come with PNP transistor outputs. However, we do supply a full range NPN or two-wire output sensor. Where possible, we recommend using sensors with inbuilt connectors. Typically, these are M12 or M8, as having a connector on the same sensor makes a simple maintenance in the future. In applications where a cable is more suitable, then we also have a wide array of sensors with the integrated cables with a range of jacket materials. We've put together a PDF guide on this process, which you can download from our website. You'll also find a link in description of the video. You'll also find a link to our web store where you can either purchase sensors or get in touch with our technical sales team who can help you identify the sensor for your application.